Okay, class, good day to us all. So today, we're going to talk about the anatomy and physiology of the respiratory system. So it's just a simple review about the respiratory system. So let us start. So the respiratory system is responsible for the exchange of gases, primarily oxygen and carbon dioxide, between the body and the environment. So that is the primary purpose of your respiratory system. So yung exchange ng carbon dioxide at saka ng oxygen. So, it consists of a various organ structure and tissues that facilitate the intake of oxygen and the removal of carbon dioxide. So, the structure itself of the respiratory system caters to this very function. So, yun yung primary function niya. But aside from that, the respiratory system serves also filters out the air na pumapasok sa katawan natin, specifically through the nostrils, kasi meron tayo dyang mga cilia, sa nasal cavity natin, because meron tayo dyang mga mucous membrane that actually traps foreign objects such as dust, pollens, na hindi natin kailangan sa loob ng katawan natin. Okay, now, let's talk about the anatomy of the respiratory system or the structure of the respiratory system itself. So, it consists of several structure. It is actually divided into two. So, you have your upper respiratory tract, and you have your lower respiratory tract. So sa upper respiratory tract, it consists of the nose, the nostril, the nasal cavity, your pharynx, your larynx, and your trachea. For the lower respiratory tract naman, you have your bronchus, you have your left and right bronchus. You also have the lungs itself, okay, the right and left lung. So, yun yung composition ng ating respiratory system. Starting off with the nasal cavity, which actually includes the nose and the nostril, is considered to be as the entry point for air para sa respiratory system natin. So, the primary functions of your nasal cavity is filtration, humidification, and warming of the incoming air. First is the filtration, kasi kagaya nga ng binanggit ko kanina, kailangan din natin i-filter yung air na pumapasok doon sa katawan natin. So, the one responsible for this is actually the nostril, which consists of cilias, yung mga hair natin, dun sa loob ng nostril natin, that traps dust particles or pollens para hindi siya makapasok sa loob. Kung meron ng mga kapasok, si nasal cavity naman has a mucosal lining that also traps foreign objects. Aside from filtration, the nasal cavity also is the one responsible for humidification ng air na pumapasok sa loob. Humidification in the sense that sinasamahan niya ng moist, okay, or moisture yung air na pumapasok, para maiwasan natin na ma-dry out yung lining ng ating respiratory system. And also, the nasal cavity warms the air bago siya pumasok doon sa respiratory system natin. So, therefore, hindi magkaroon ng biglang temperature drop yung lining ng respiratory system. So, that's the primary function of your nasal cavity. Now, baba naman tayo. So, the pharynx naman, also known as your throat, the pharynx can be considered to be as both part of the respiratory system and the digestive system or the gastrointestinal tract. It serves as a passage for the nasal cavity and the oral cavity, yung meats. So, yung oral cavity natin is yung pinaka-mouth natin. So, sa bandang likod nun, the throat itself is considered to be the pharynx, that's the oropharynx. And the upper part naman is the nasopharynx. So, sila yung, what do you call this, the juncture ng oral at saka nasal. So, both food and air pumapasok sa pharynx because it serves as a common pathway for both air and food. Okay, nasopharynx is directly connected to your nasal cavity while the oropharynx naman is directly connected to your oral cavity. Now, so how about the voice box? So, the voice box or the larynx itself contains the vocal cords and aids in phonation. It's not responsible for respiration, but it's still considered to be as a part of your respiratory system because it is responsible, it is considered to be also as a pathway ng air, dito rin dumadaan. But the primary purpose of the larynx or the voice box itself is yung phonation. So, production of sounds para makapagsalita tayo. Now, the larynx is directly connected to the pharynx at the top and the trachea at the bottom. Okay. Now, the trachea is considered to be as your windpipe. It's a tube made of cartilage rings that carries air from the lungs into the larynx into to the lungs. So basically, the trachea itself, also known as the windpipe, is a protection. Parang pinoprotektahan niya yung ating pathway. So it's composed of cartilaginous rings that surrounds the pathway, okay, ng air natin, okay? So next will be the bronchial tree. So nandun na tayo ngayon sa lower respiratory tract, so sa bronchial tree natin or sa bronchus. So the bronchial tree, it branches off from the trachea into two bronchi, one for each lung, which further divide into smaller bronchioles within the lungs. So yung bronchial tree natin o yung bronchus natin, nagsisimula siya at the lower part of the trachea wherein magdi-divide siya or magbabranch siya into two. So dalawa to. So isa para sa left lung at isa para sa right lung. Okay. Now of course, let's talk about the most important component of the respiratory system, and that will be the lungs. So the lungs is a paired organs containing air sacs called the alveoli, where gas exchange actually occurs. So the lungs, the left lung and the right lung have lobes. So yung ating right lungs, meron siyang 3 lobes, and the left lung has 2 lobes. Now, the smallest unit of the lungs is known as your alveoli. So alveoli is also known as your air sacs. Dito nangyayari yung gas exchange between oxygen and carbon dioxide. Okay? So that is for the anatomy of your respiratory system. It's quite simple. Now let's talk about the physiology or the functions of the respiratory system. So ano ba ang purpose ng ating respiratory system? Now, so the primary purpose of your respiratory system is yung tinatawag natin na pulmonary ventilation. So pulmonary ventilation is wherein we conduct inhalation and exhalation. In inhalation, the diaphragm and intercostal muscle contract, expanding the thoracic cavity, reducing air pressure, and drawing air into the lungs. So inhalation is intake of air. So pag nagkaroon tayo ng intake of air, dito yung lungs natin, yung ating lungs ngayon will be filled up of oxygen, and not just oxygen but other contents ng hangin or ng air. Pero ang primary na kailangan natin doon is of course the oxygen. Okay, so during inhalation, yung diaphragm natin and intercostal muscle will contract, okay, producing air pressure para hatakin yung air sa labas into the lungs itself, where it will fill up the alveoli with oxygen, and then magkakaroon ngayon ng exchange ng oxygen and carbon dioxide. Now, during exhalation naman, the diaphragm and intercostal muscle relax naman, magre-relax naman yung diaphragm natin at saka yung intercostal muscles natin, increasing air pressure and forcing air out of the lungs naman. So yun yung tinatawag natin na pulmonary ventilation. So you have your inhalation and you have your exhalation. Okay. Now let's talk about gas exchange. Okay, during inhalation and exhalation, nagkakaroon tayo tinatawag natin ng gas exchange. Specifically external gas exchange, kasi dalawa 'yan. You have your internal and you have your external. Yung external gas exchange is the exchange of your oxygen and carbon dioxide, which happens in the alveoli. Okay, sa alveoli natin, inside the lungs. While your internal gas exchange naman, nangyayari ito sa cell mismo, kung saan nagkakaroon ng exchange ng carbon dioxide at ng oxygen sa cellular level. Now, oxygen from inhaled air diffuses across the alveolar membrane into the blood, into the capillaries. So, yung oxygen na in-inhale natin due to the process of diffusion will cross the alveolar membrane into the blood, into the capillaries. Ganun din yung nangyayari sa carbon dioxide, but in reverse. So yung carbon dioxide naman natin, which actually produced by cellular respiration, diffuses from the blood naman into the capillaries, into the alveoli to be exhaled. So that what happened in your gas exchange. Again, this is your external gas exchange. Okay? Now, so for the transport of gases, oxygen is transported by the red blood cells attached to your hemoglobin. So during the gas exchange, pag nag-diffuse na yung oxygen natin into your bloodstream, it will attach, the oxygen itself will attach to the red blood cells, specifically to the hemoglobin. While carbon dioxide naman is transported in the blood mainly as bicarbonate ions, also bounded to your hemoglobin. The difference in the color of the blood, pag oxygen-rich blood, rich red yung kulay niya. Talagang rich red. Okay? Pag naman carbon dioxide, medyo darker yung coloration ng dugo. Okay? Okay. For the regulation of respiration, so kagaya nga na napag-usapan natin before with regards to your conduction system of the heart, you don't need to think about it. Yung respiration, it's a two-way process. Not two-way process, ano? Dalawa siya. Meaning, you can control it and it can also control itself automatically. So, for the control of, for the automatic control of the respiration, it happens in the brainstem, specifically in the medulla oblongata. So, the respiratory system, respiratory center is located in your medulla. So, the medulla is the one responsible for respiration. So, yung medulla natin, nagre-respond siya with the level of carbon dioxide and oxygen and even the pH in the blood. So, meaning, pag mababa ang oxygen and mataas ang carbon dioxide, the medulla will send the diaphragm and the intercostal muscle to contract, causing inhalation. Okay, so ganun na nangyayari, ano? So if you cannot actually hold your breath for so long. Automatic 'yun, hindi mo makokontrol. You can hold your breath, but after a while, pag masyado nang mababa yung level of oxygen and carbon dioxide sa katawan natin, si medulla will take over. So wala kang magagawa doon, ano? You are still going to be inhaling and exhaling because of the respiratory center. Okay? So that's the review of the respiratory system. I hope na maiintindihan nyo. So we will now proceed with our next lesson in the next video. So bye, class.